Hello friends, myself Amar. In this video, I will discuss about the JSF action event. Okay, let me show you what I have done. In the index.xhtml page, I have created a button, that is a command button, having the value as click. Okay, now to associate the action event with the command button, there are two ways, and both the ways I have discussed here. Let me discuss the first one. Here what I have done, the value is click. And the ID of the button I have given as btn click, right? And here I have written f colon action listener. This f is nothing but the prefix of this core tag which has action listener. And in the action listener, I have specified type equals to com.ripplescode.mydemo. This means whenever I will click on this button, at that time, this mydemo class will fire. Now, if you can see here, I have created the mydemo class. In the MyDemo class, what I have done, I have implemented the action listener interface, and this action listener interface is present inside javafx.faces.event package. Okay, this action listener interface contains a method which is called as the process action. That's why I have overrided this method. And in this method, what I have done, I have printed the ID of the component for which this event is generated. Okay. That's why what will happen, whenever I will click on this button, this MyDemo class will fire, and in the MyDemo class, this process action method will be called, and this will print the ID of the component which has generated the event. This can be one of the way. Another way is, I have created another button having the value is click, ID as btn click 1. And here itself, there is an attribute which is called as the action listener. In the action listener, I have written mybin.processAction. This mybin is nothing but the name of the managed bin. Here, if you can see, here I have created this managed bin, that is mybin. And in the mybin, I have created a function with the name processAction. And in the processAction function, I have printed the ID of the control for which the event is generated. Okay. That's why here I have written mybin.processAction. This means whenever I will click on this button, then the processAction method of the managed bin will be called, and that function will print the ID of the control for which the event is generated. Okay. Let me show you the output. Let me run this. Yes. Now here I am clicking. Click here. Here if you can see, I have used system.out.println, right? That's why, let me go to the output and here go to the GlassPiece server, because I am using GlassPiece server. See, the ID of the button is btn click for the first button, right? And if we click here on the second button, then again it should print the ID, and this time the ID should be btn click 1 because I have clicked it for the second button, right? This is how we can use the action event in JSF, by using a normal class and by using a managed bin. Okay, I hope you like my video. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you so much.